Någonstans i en skog sitter vargen och glor på en ensam måne där uppe.
Hi everybody, this is Mattias, and today I'm going to show you the vocoder within Bitwig Studio. The best way to show how a vocoder actually works is probably by doing a live performance. So today we're going to play Hide and Seek by Imogen Heap. And maybe you heard this track before, sampled by Jason Derulo. Anyways, my name is Mattias, and let's take the tour.
Where are we? What the hell is going on? The dust has only just begun to fall. Crop circles in the carpet, sinking feeling. Spin me round again and rub my eyes. This can't be happening.
Yeah, so that was my little performance of Imogen Heap's Hide and Seek. It's a small snippet, but you get the point on how this vocoder effect can be a really huge and a powerful thing in your music. So let's look at this preset and see how the preset was designed and how the vocoder actually works. You can get this preset and I will upload the project so you can play around with it too. So yeah, you can check the links in the description to this video. So what we have here is the vocoder, and we have a modulator, which in this case is my voice into the microphone. Then the audio is split up into 64 different filter bands, frequency bands, and you can also set the width for these bands. The best way to learn about the devices in Bitwig Studio is pressing a device like this, so it's selected, a little bit of lightish gray. Then you can go into the information panel here and press show help. And it will bring up this specific focused view on our specific device. In this case, the vocoder, and we can see here that imposes the spectrum of one sound onto another sound. So basically, we have the microphone here, my voice into the modulator, and we have a synthesizer playing some chords as the carrier. And you can read up on the different parameters and switches here on the device if you want to learn more about the vocoder. But basically, in the carrier we have a note receiver, so I have the MIDI actually being played on a separate track here, which is called the MIDI to vocoder. You can see the chords here, and the chords are sent into this note receiver and into the polysynth. And the polysynth is just a basic preset with we have four voices of unison for a sawtooth and a little bit of one octave below with square, which is just a single voice. And that's just to get a little bit more low end on this sound. And we have some, yeah, a little bit of reverb on this vocoded sound too. And with the vocoder, we can also select to mix the dry signal with the more wet signal. So we can, if we drag this all the way up, we will get a very robotic and just hear this vocoded sound. So let's listen to this sample. Yeah, so that's typically how you would hear a vocoded effect in maybe a song from Daft Punk or something. But I like to mix in a little bit of the dry vocals, maybe have the vocoder set at 55-56% wetness. So we get a little bit of the dryness and a little bit of the vocoded signal.
Någonstans i en skog sitter vargen och glor på en ensam måne där uppe.
And with this vocoder in Bitwig, we can actually select how many bands this modulator and carrier signal will be split into. But generally, you want to have the bands quite high, so you get a more accurate sample or rendition of your vocals. But if you drag this down to, say, 8 bands, it will sound more robotic.
Någonstans i en skog sitter vargen och glor på en ensam måne där uppe.
Let's drag that up to 80 bands, which is the max setting within the vocoder in Bitwig.
Någonstans i en skog sitter vargen och glor på en ensam måne där uppe.
So that way we get a more smooth result, a more smooth signal.
Where are we? Crop circles in the carpet, sinking, feeling.
Yeah, so this is typically my favorite way of using the vocoder. So you have a little bit of the dry signal and a little bit of that vocoded signal. And yeah, as I said earlier, you will have this preset and the project available in the description to this video. So you can download the project and play around with the settings of this preset. And if you have a hard time singing the correct pitch, you can always add an auto pitch in the beginning before the vocoder, which will make it sound even more robotic and, yeah, like an Android. So here I have the M auto pitch, and let's activate it. I think that this was in A major, so we set it to A major. And yeah, I will not include this MELDA auto pitch within the preset, because maybe you don't have it, but this is a free plugin, so I highly suggest that you go grab it if you want to use it with your vocoding. So let's activate it and see how that sounds.
Where are we? What the hell is going on? The dust has only just begun to fall. Crop circles in the carpet, sinking feeling.
Yeah, so that's some tips on how you can use the vocoder in Bitwig Studio 3.1. If you have any questions on the vocoder or using Bitwig Studio, please write them in the comments section below. Now you can continue and watch my next video. Fear not, if you don't have Bitwig Studio yet, you can always grab Bitwig with my affiliate link in the description. And there's also a discount code which will give you 10% on a new version of Bitwig Studio. Thanks a million for all the new subscribers, and if you're new, subscribe, hit the like, write some nice feedback, and yeah. My name is Mattias, and see you in the next video. Bye!